In case you didn't know, I have started learning Style3d so far, and they just updated to version 8, which I've been playing around with, and so far it's pretty cool. But no matter what 3D program I'm in, I want to be able to customize the avatar. And Style3d's avatar editor is even better than I realized. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I talk about digital fashion design software and communication for fashion entrepreneurs on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. If you saw this video, you heard me discuss avatar customization, why it's so important, and some of the options that at the time were only available in Browzwear's avatar editor. And while Clo3d has made some significant updates to their avatar editor, there are still a few things that I think are lacking. So when I started checking out Style3d's editor, I was looking for some specific things that would fill in those gaps. And I have to say, I was very pleasantly surprised. To get to the avatar editor, the first thing you need to do is put an avatar onto the screen. So I'm going to the avatar icon in the object browser and click on Go to Library. From there, choose your gender. The last few avatars I think of as your template or starting point. Each has kind of a general shape, so choose whichever generally represents the shape of your avatar, and then you can continue to customize from there. Double-click the avatar, and then click OK in the next window. If there are additional updates you want to make, like changing the hair, appearance, shoes, etc., you can do that here, but a lot of it you can also change in the property editor. So click any part of the avatar or select the avatar in the object browser, and any editable attributes of the avatar appear in the property editor below. So I'm going to change the avatar to Ada. I'm going to change her pose to straight A, change her hand gestures to elegant 01, change her emotion to a smile. I'll leave the pixie hair and underwear, but I will change her shoes to Converse. That alone is pretty cool, just to get an overall more interesting avatar. But now I'm going to go into the avatar editor to make updates to the avatar's measurements and to refine the other appearance updates I made even further. With the avatar still selected, if you scroll to the top of the property editor, you'll see a button labeled Edit Avatar. And when you select it, another window opens that allows you to further refine the avatar's size, face, emotion, animation, and arrangement. This video is going to focus on the size, face, and emotion, and I'm going to spend the most time on the size because I think this is where designers will get the most value. If you indeed saw that video I referred to earlier, you'll note some of the specific areas that I thought were important as far as avatar customization, and I was really happy to see that Style3d addresses all of these as well. The first thing you can do if you're using the default avatars is scroll through whether you want a small, medium, large, or extra large size. And yes, I know we're customizing this, but you want to start with an avatar that's close to the measurements you're using. So if that default medium is a little too small or too big now that you can see the measurements, you can quickly jump to a different size without leaving the editor. The next thing you'll notice is that there is a basic and advanced editor. And the basic editor is already pretty robust, but you can get even more granular with your measurements in the advanced editor. This will probably be really great for anyone doing custom or bespoke work. From here, you can go through and update measurements as needed. And there are a few things I wanted to point out that I think are unique and pretty cool to have as an option in Style3d. Before I get started, I'm going to press Alt or Option D so that I can see the measurements directly on the avatar as I'm making the updates. I think that's going to be particularly helpful for these first two settings, muscle and plus size. The plus size slider is great because it starts to proportionally increase the size of the avatar, again, allowing you to start a bit closer to the size you may need. Muscle does a similar thing in that it increases or decreases the overall musculature of the avatar. This upper body editor, I think, is a real game changer for anyone doing intimate apparel, swim, corsets, anything where you really need to define the bust. First of all, huge win that you can choose a cup size. Then you can also customize the lower chest measurement and the bust measurement, and choose what measurements you want to see at the same time as you're changing them. You can customize the bust point in case your apex is closer or farther apart. And this is called something else in Style3d, but I like to refer to this as the bust drop, something that I think is also critical to fitting a garment correctly. Circumference details are pretty standard, but let's move down to the lower body hip details. And for this one, I'm going to turn the avatar to the side view. So this detail is what I was referring to in my previous video in that Bonita Applebaum reference. The hip size and hip shape allow you much more control over where you're increasing the hip width. Because for some of us, we're not just getting wider this way. Some of us have a little extra width this way. And it makes a huge difference in how your clothes fit when that's accounted for. And then the hip breadth completes the overall shape of the hip, whether you're a little more sculpted in that area or a bit more round and hourglassy. Thigh, mid-thigh, and knee can also be customized, which is amazing. Bicep, elbow, forearm, and wrist, also pretty standard, as well as calf and ankle. But the other two sections I also appreciate, being someone who is short-waisted with long legs and not a tall person, but usually need tall pants because my legs are long. First off, the center front and center back neck to waist allows me to adjust it so my avatar is also short-waisted. And a quick note, if you lock the height, it will make these body length adjustments that I'm doing now without adjusting the height of the avatar. And when it comes to the leg length, you can adjust the inseam as well as the thigh and calf length, which I think is pretty incredible. So it's really not going off of what is considered standard. You can really customize this avatar to whatever your body is. Once you're happy with the measurements, be sure to save them so that you can reload and apply them later to any avatar. So all of that is amazing, and for me, could be enough if I'm creating clothing. Like, that's the most important part. But you can go even further and have a bit more fun with customizing your avatar by adjusting the face. So here, as with the body measurements, you have lots of options. You can change your avatar's face shape, the eyes, the nose, the mouth, eyebrows, lashes. I mean, you can literally make this avatar look like they just had plastic surgery. And then on top of that, you can change the avatar's emotion. Once you're done, close the window and your avatar is ready to go. And remember, if you want to do any quick customization, like maybe update her expression because this one is a little creepy, you can quickly change it in the property editor. So this process made me really happy to see the level of avatar customization I can do. And it made me even more excited to keep working in Style3d. Thanks for watching today's video. If you're interested in starting your journey with 3D fashion design software, I invite you to check out some of my other videos on this channel and check out my 3D course, which I'll link below in the description. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week. And I'll see you next time.